After many years of stagnation, I have finally added some much-needed features to Photosounder, like the ability to import multiple files onto different layers of a same project, a new interface system that allows me to make some much-needed dialogs, fast convolution between layers, ultrasounds, and more. For the last 4 years, I've been doing something a bit unusual. Instead of working on a commercial project, I've been working on a library of general-purpose code, and to make that library mature quickly, I made many small projects based on it until I felt that the whole thing was ready. When you make a large software project, you need a lot of things, but mainly things not specific to your project, like how to load sounds and images, or how to put things on a screen and create an interface. By putting all these things into a well-organized library, I can take advantage of all these features while making the code specific to my project stay simple and better organized. So the effort put into the library trickles down, and with little effort, any project based on that library can quickly achieve a lot. Until now, Photosounder's interface was rather limited, which got in the way of me developing it further. Now that I finally can make dialogs, I can do a lot of things that I couldn't do before. I already added a few dialogs, like this one. When you made a new project, it just used default settings without asking anything. Now you get to choose the parameters in whatever unit you like better, and in the case of duration, you can even set it in minutes and seconds. So if you want 4 minutes and 30 seconds, you can just type this. The open dialog is by far the most significant change, and there are other big changes tied to it. As before, you can open files like this, but now you can also drag and drop your files from a folder to the window. In both cases, you'll end up with a dialog that, depending on the file type and context, will give you options. If you load an image or an archive, there are no options. You're good to go and press load. But if you load a sound, you get a second dialog where you can choose options for how to turn the sound into an image. The defaults are pretty good, so usually you can ignore that, but let's look at the options. You can change the frequency range, and you can even go into infrasounds. Since a few people who use Photosounder to study ultrasonic bat calls asked me, now you can also go into the ultrasounds. All of that to work correctly, you'll need to adjust your sampling rate in the configuration file to something suitable, because sounds are resampled to that sampling rate when loaded. So in practice, you can analyze ultrasounds that go up to almost 200 kHz. The time resolution is a fairly obvious one. By default, we have 100 columns of pixels for every second of sound. Likewise, the pitch resolution by default gives you 60 pixels per octave. This one could perhaps use a bit of increasing if you want more definition in the highs. Something like 120 pixels per octave is a reasonable choice. The next two parameters are a bit less obvious. At some point when you get to the low frequencies, the original time and pitch resolution can't both be maintained. So after the time resolution drops to the transition resolution, the pitch resolution is dropped to maintain that transition time resolution, and when the minimum pitch resolution is reached, then it's the time resolution that goes down again. If you want time resolution to remain constant, which is needed when working with volume dynamics and envelopes, then you can set the minimum pitch resolution to zero. And then there's what I call the frequency scale. I could never find a suitable name for this, but what it does is that if the value is 2, the frequency scale is logarithmic. If it's 1, it's linear, which is useful for a few specific cases like analyzing a sound to find an image hidden in it. Given that it's best to put an image in sound using a linear frequency scale to make the top and the bottom of the image have the same image quality. And everything in between is just something in between. And finally, we have the channel section. By default, everything is mixed to mono. That is until I add stereo support, but you can also select the left or right channel. So you can work on one channel at a time, then join the two channels using this function. If you've used all the versions of Photosounder, you'll notice how analyzing sounds is now much faster. That's because I've changed how loading is done, but also because it doesn't show the image as it loads. Now we can also have projects that contain multiple files. In the past, if you tried opening another file, it will always replace whatever you had loaded. But now instead, you can open files on new layers on top of your current project. If you already have a project open, then when you try to open a file, it gives you two options. Either make it a new project, which replaces everything you had open, or add to the current project, which will add the file to a new layer, in which case you can choose how it will be added. By default, the new file will be made to fit vertically, because typically all images and sounds will have to fit the default frequency range, and by default, the project will be extended horizontally in time, only if the new file is longer than the project. So for each dimension, you have three import options, either crop, which means you don't change the project and you don't rescale the new image either, so it gets cut if it's too long, or fit, which will squeeze or stretch the new image to fit the project's dimensions, or extend, which adds room to the project if needed. In the future, I will add a way to rescale and reposition each layer. That will help a lot, but it's one of those things I couldn't do for this update without delaying it further. You can definitely expect smaller updates soon in the future, with new functionality like rescaling layers, redimensioning the whole project, maybe a dialog to manage layers better, and more. If you press F3, you can bring up a console that allows you to type commands, the kind that are contained in a history file and that are described in the Photosounder archive specification. If, for example, we want to double the duration of a project by padding, sadly there's no dialog to do this yet. That will come later. For now, we can type this in the console and press run. Or you can use that to rename a layer, like this. If you're into scripting, you can use this to test commands and see how they work. You can also use the contents of a history file for inspiration. Another important update is fast convolution, which is especially welcome now that we can have two files each on a layer and convolve them together to obtain really wild results. Convolution has been in Photosounder since 2010, and it's still the only image editor that allows you to convolve between two layers. But few users of Photosounder know what it does, which is a shame because it's a really powerful and fun effect. But until now, convolution in Photosounder could be very slow. Now it uses a much faster implementation, and it even uses your GPU to speed things up further. It also keeps convolution results to avoid having to compute the same thing twice. So adding convolution somewhere between two layers won't slow everything else down. In a nutshell, convolution means replacing every pixel in one image with an entire copy of the other image. So if on one you have a horizontal line and on the other you have a vertical line, then every point of one of those lines is replaced with an entire copy of the other line. So you get some kind of rectangle. And that's a great way to make complex images and complex sounds without much effort. So if you want interesting results quickly, I recommend experimenting with combining layers with the top layer having the convolution mode. I also recommend using images and sounds with a lot of dark for best results. Bright images tend to turn into a wall of noise too easily. Now, instead of saving images to an 8-bit BMP format, we can save to a 32-bit floating point TIFF, which is much better, obviously. I also changed the configuration file. Now it's nicer and much more self-explanatory. And I added a sound volume limiter, just to make sure you can't accidentally produce ear-destroying sounds. If the volume is above the given limit, the volume is instantly lowered and kept at that level for at least a few seconds. That's about it for this update. I will probably release minor updates soon. As for the next large update, I haven't yet decided what I will make it about. I have much to choose from. It could have layer rescaling, or live lossless resynthesis, or stereo support, sound recording, better management of layers. I just don't know yet. If you'd like to try the demo, the link is in the description. If you already have a license of Photosounder, you might already have access to this new version. Just go on the download page and enter the email you used when buying, and the link will be sent to that email address. If you have a license, you will also be able to try beta versions as they appear. I also plan on making more videos explaining how certain things work, like convolution or scripting. Let me know if there's any topic you'd like me to explain.